Now, coming out of Daytona, teammates, one of the big themes. And they're starting to become a little development. What do teammates really mean in NASCAR? Our Shannon Spake took on the challenge and took a look.
An alley-oop.
Gibson.
A touchdown pass.
Manning looking, takes a hit as he fires downfield. He has a wide open receiver, touchdown.
A double play.
Let's see if they turn two. There's one. There's two.
The results of teammates working together. But in NASCAR, the outcome is sometimes different, as demonstrated by Tony Stewart and Denny Hamlin last weekend in Daytona.
Well, it's just stupid when you got your teammate in front of you and he decides he's going to check up and turn for him.
On Friday, Stewart's words still stung.
You know, he totally threw me under the bus in front of millions of people on TV. No, I'm not angry. I'm just disappointed.
They may wear the same team names on their shirts, but according to drivers, when the green flag drops, teammates cease to exist.
They're not your teammates, really, because if they were, they would only be on the track to make sure you won. It's not the correct terminology.
We are business partners, you know, the way I look at it, and we fully expect our two teammates to try to outrun us. That's what we fully expect. We also fully expect, though, that if they do outrun us, that they're going to tell us why.
You work with one another as much as you can, but at the same time, when you get to the end of the race, you've got to do what you can for your team and for your sponsor.
Drafting tracks like Daytona are really the only place where teammates could actually help each other out. And according to Carl Edwards, the final lap of last week's race in Daytona was the first time he was able to help a teammate win a race. He said even though he thinks he may have been able to get by Jamie McMurray, helping a teammate take the checkers was pretty cool. In Joliet, Illinois, Shannon Spake, ESPN.
Now over to NASCAR Now insider Marty Smith, who joins us. Marty, you heard about teammates and the theme about teammates. Where do we stand right now between the Gibbs teammates, Denny Hamlin, and of course Tony Stewart?
I think they both want to move on, Eric. I had a pretty extensive conversation today with Denny Hamlin, and he told me that when he saw his phone ring earlier this week, he got a new phone. He saw it ring earlier this week, saw the number, didn't recognize it. Tony Stewart had called. He didn't answer it because he didn't know who was calling him. That's his policy. I'm not answering it if I don't know who you are. Ultimately, he heard the message, but he decided at that moment, look, it's not smart for me to call back. It's only going to incite another argument and escalate this thing further. So he waited the entire week. They didn't talk until they got here today. So I do think they'll be able to move on from this. But I think both parties learned a lot from this.
Well, when you see the comments, Denny Hamlin doesn't seem like he's very happy right now. Thrown under the bus, millions of people. What do you make of his comments today?
Here's what he told me after the group session there in speaking with him. He said, look, man, it did hurt. It hurt me pretty bad. How would you like to have the whole world told that you're not a good teammate when I would do anything in the world for my teammates? It did really hit Denny Hamlin very deep. And again, it took him the entire week to decide he was ready to talk about this. So, I'm not sure that there wasn't some sort of undercurrent that Tony Stewart was trying to accomplish by saying that in the media, that maybe he did feel like Denny Hamlin needed to be a better teammate. But it definitely got Denny Hamlin's attention. He was none too happy about it.
For the record, Marty Smith, an outstanding teammate.